What about gluten?
So gluten is a type of protein that is mostly present in wheat and rye and some barley. So gluten is something that you need to avoid if you have a disease called celiac. If people have a disease called celiac, where they have, you know, gut problems and bloatings, but that's only 1 out of 100 people. But majority, like for 95 to 99% of the people, whole grain foods, which are minimally processed, are beneficial for us because you have a good source of fiber, antioxidants, B vitamins. So they are beneficial for a majority of us. So you only need to avoid gluten if you have celiac.
Yeah, let's say even if you want to avoid gluten, go for the foods that do not have gluten. For example, rice, quinoa, millet, sorghum. Instead of going for gluten-free processed products because they have a lot of oil and...
They have egg. So if you go store-bought gluten-free foods, if you go buy store-bought gluten-free food, first thing is they're expensive. Second thing is they have like oils, eggs, dairy products, and heavily processed. So only people who need to go gluten-free are who have celiac.
Yeah. So why do some doctors recommend you go gluten-free if you don't have celiac?
How much education that doctor has for nutrition? So the reason why they're recommending is there are some books out there recently, which are, one book is Wheat Belly, and that's by Dr. William Davis, and then there is another book called Grain Brain, right? These two people are promoting high, heavily animal-based foods, and they're asking people to cut down on the carbs. So that will work in the short term. When you go eat that way of eating, that will work on short term to help you lose weight. But in the long run, you're increasing inflammation. You're like, you know, increasing the risk of kidney disease, heart disease, liver disease, cancers.
So I have a friend of mine, and she's gluten-free.
Yeah.
And her doctor recommended it, but she does not have celiac.
Yeah.
And she still has a lot of inflammation. She still has a hard time getting around. So it's not benefiting her.
No, majority of the people, it doesn't benefit.
Yeah. Because if you're taking the other products, if it's loaded with oil, that's increasing your inflammation. So it...
She buys all gluten-free pasta,
gluten-free
everything. Yeah, most of these gluten-free foods, as I just mentioned, loaded with oil, loaded with processed flour, loaded with sugar, loaded with eggs, loaded with dairy products, all the things that would increase inflammation. See, the gluten-free is a myth. It's a myth that is going around, and it's just a popular thing right now.
Yeah.
And these kind of popular trends in nutrition, they'll go up and down. You'll hear a lot about, oh, go keto diet, or go Atkins diet, or go paleo diet. These are all...
Coconut oil is good for you.
Coconut oil is good. These are all the fads, are the myths that circulate for a short period of time, about 5 to 10 years, and then they die down. What we're talking about, if you look at the research that was presented yesterday, the evidence, the substantial evidence for this has been there for over 100 years.